Jury selection continues at 9 this morning for George Zimmerman's second-degree murder trial. That's after only 4 would-be jurors were questioned in the courtroom on the first day. WESH 2 Stuart Moore is live at the Seminole County Courthouse right now. And Stuart, how many jurors do these attorneys need to select?
They only need 6 people to actually sit on the jury, Jason, and then about 4 to 5 alternates who will also be in the courtroom during the proceedings. Yesterday, they did give out that questionnaire in the morning to 500 people who actually entered the courtroom. They narrowed it down to a certain amount of number. 4 of those people actually got to talk yesterday, and then today, the judges called back 20 more.
20 more potential jurors will take the stand to determine if they should be seated to serve for the George Zimmerman second-degree murder trial. On day 1, 500 people filled out questionnaires during the morning, and court only had time to interview 4 prospective jurors Monday. All said they could be objective if they were chosen.
Could you estimate how many times you may have heard or read or talked about the case?
The judge has ordered that the potential jurors have their names and faces not broadcast by anyone, and for the remaining 20 that come today, they were not allowed to watch any coverage or talk about the selection process or post to social networks. WESH 2's legal analyst says the group they are choosing from has not been plugged into every aspect of the trial.
We want is somebody that knows a little bit but doesn't know too much. We want somebody that's willing to be fair but hasn't based their opinion on anything other than that they're going to try to be fair.
As the day went on, Zimmerman.
And back here live, George Zimmerman, actually they had sent out a questionnaire that yesterday that the people were answering. And question number 4 is what the judge actually used to divide up the different groups of people to be questioned, whether or not to rule some people out altogether. We're not exactly sure what that question was, but we think that it had a lot to do with their pretrial exposure to this case. This morning's hearings begin at 9 a.m. Reporting live from the Seminole County Courthouse, Stuart Moore, WESH 2 News.